dismissed the Trump administration on the first day on the job. That allegation important because it suggests that Flynn's well-documented push to undermine U.S. sanctions against Russia could have also been an effort to help himself or his friends, not America, and that can always make your legal problems worse. Now, we have been working here for some time on a special report tonight about how a federal law, the Logan Act, could apply in the Trump era, and that was before this avalanche of headlines today about Mike Flynn having this other reason for spiking sanctions against Russia. So it's an apt time to look at the Logan Act and why some of the White House's arguments might not help Flynn that much. We may be hearing a lot more about this 200-year-old law.
I don't think it's wrong for a transition person to talk to a foreign government about changing policy. I don't think the Logan Act is worth the papers written on.
It is the constitutional right, even of a presidency in its final days, to conduct the foreign policy of the United States without interference. And people say it's the Logan Act, it's 218 years old, it's still a law on the books.
A lot of the focus has been on this Logan Act and about the incoming administration and the Trump team in transition reaching out to foreign governments.
The Logan Act is an old law that boils down to one word, unauthorized. It makes it a crime to hold unauthorized negotiations or discussions with other countries. And in his plea, Mike Flynn admitted to talking to Russia about undercutting U.S. sanctions. And prosecutors could potentially argue that unauthorized outreach was a crime under the Logan Act, depends on the details. Now, let's be clear. The U.S. has only prosecuted two people for this kind of crime. Neither was convicted. And Trump allies say that sparse record makes any prosecution here a stretch. Trump's lawyer arguing the act certainly does not apply to a presidential transition team because they're government employees heading into office. But that itself is actually widely debated. President Reagan, a leading GOP voice on foreign policy, argued for a broader application of the Logan Act, a point he made when slamming Reverend Jesse Jackson's 1984 trip to lobby Cuban officials.
There is a law, the Logan Act, with regard to unauthorized personnel, civilians simply going to our citizens to other countries and, in effect, negotiating with foreign governments.
Nothing legal has been challenged. Something moral has been challenged.
Now, that particular debate never played out in court. Unlike Flynn, Jackson was also just purely a private citizen. But a few years later, the Reagan administration was back at it, suggesting a government official, the Speaker of the House, should stop private meetings that undermined U.S. negotiations abroad.
The Reagan administration was highly annoyed over the private meeting.
Tom Brokaw, I don't have to get the approval of anybody except the people. I work for the people. I work for the United States. And in this instance, I like to think I make some small contribution toward peace.
And that was the House Speaker defending against this, Reagan and other Republicans saying his active resistance in Nicaragua was a violation of the Logan Act. Now, that's how some Republicans have previously viewed the Logan Act, a law that at least could apply to government officials. Others have invoked the law back when the words President Trump were more of a punchline than a daily salutation. President Obama was making the Iran deal, and Republicans sent an open letter against it to Iran. People thought that might have undercut the deal by warning that it wouldn't hold in the future, sparking discussions about whether being pen pals with Iran could also lead to charges.
Again, I wonder if these 47 senators gave thought to what they were doing here. Then again, as I said in the beginning of this show, they did know exactly what they were doing. They were trying to undermine the work of an American president by, first of all, disrespecting him, even if they don't get charged and imprisoned for it. What they've done here is craven.
By the time Donald Trump asked Russia to hack Clinton's emails, the top Democrat on the Homeland Security Committee was saying Trump should be investigated for violating the Logan Act.
The notion he would invite a foreign nation to conduct an attack against our country, it's just beyond the pale, and I believe it violates the Logan Act, and I think he should be investigated for that.
Now, that investigation did not occur, but the filing that Bob Mueller made against Flynn does read like a nightmare for several unnamed staffers who are referred to as presidential transition official, senior members of the transition team, very senior member. Now, news reports have identified some of those people, but only Mueller really knows who he is referring to. Now, do they face Logan Act exposure? Here's the bottom line from our reporting and what we've seen. Number one, the Logan Act is rarely prosecuted, but it can apply to unauthorized diplomacy. Number two, if you have a case, it would be stronger if the diplomacy undercuts the policy of the U.S. defined by the president at the time. And as a matter of both law and physics, there's one president at a time. Mike Flynn was doing Russian outreach during Obama's presidency. A third takeaway here. Bob Mueller is willing to assertively charge rare crimes. Before this probe started, there were only 7 prosecutions for foreign lobbying violations in all of American history. Today, there are 9, because Bob Mueller charged both Manafort and Gates under a different, pretty obscure law. Now, Mueller may have been ready to charge Flynn for this or other laws, which could explain why he pleaded guilty to a felony, or maybe not. But fourth and finally, there is one other reason that secret unauthorized diplomacy was probably so rarely prosecuted in the last 200 years. Some of it must have stayed secret. But in the past few decades, the surveillance in this country around the world has skyrocketed. Consider that the reason we even know Flynn was talking to the Russian ambassador is that it was recorded. The reason Paul Manafort's bail deal was getting scuttled this week? Well, Mueller caught him secretly talking to a Russian. And while we don't know how, several experts say surveillance would be the most likely explanation that Mueller busted Manafort again this week and so quickly. Now, if there's suddenly way more surveillance of foreign contacts, there may be more records of potentially illegal foreign contacts. And I think that brings us back to a key rule to keep in mind anytime you're tracking a criminal probe. Prosecutions are not just about crime. Most crimes are never charged. Prosecutions are always about evidence. Does it exist? Who gets their hands on it? Well, Mike Flynn knew he had secrets about his contact with Russia. He just thought he could keep them as secrets. But it turns out Bob Mueller could hear him. And anyone on the wrong end of this special counsel should consider how his investigative work does fit that old classic by the Romantics. I hear the secrets that you keep when you're talking in your sleep. Keep talking if you want, but Bob Mueller might be listening.